Hey, what's up, guys? So after waiting for several months, my new $14,000 fully loaded 18-core iMac Pro has finally arrived. And the question has to be asked, is it worth the money? So in this video, we're going to run some tests to compare it to my fully loaded iMac that I bought for less than half the price at $6,000 and determine how much faster the iMac Pro is and if it's worth the extra cash. So here we have opened up Premiere Pro and we'll be using clips from three different cameras, a Red 8K clip, a 1DX Mark II 4K clip, and a DJI Phantom 4 Pro 4K clip. So let's dive in and see how they compare. First, we'll compare the speed of the 8K Red clip playing back at full resolution. As you can see, the iMac Pro plays back 8K at full resolution without dropping any frames, whereas the iMac is struggling pretty bad, so I had to turn the resolution down to 1/8 on the iMac to get the same flawless playback as the iMac Pro. Now with the 1DX Mark II clip, they both played back the 4K footage pretty flawlessly. And then with the Phantom 4 Pro 4K clip, again, they both do a pretty good job playing back. But once I sped up both clips times two, the iMac Pro was still playing back flawlessly while the iMac was much laggier. So again, I had to turn down the resolution to 1/8 on the iMac to get the same flawless playback. Next, I tested out the rendering speeds. The iMac Pro renders about twice as fast, and same thing with exporting, the iMac Pro exports out twice as fast. An interesting test though was applying warp stabilizer. Warp stabilizer actually performs 25% better on the iMac. So it's important to be aware that different softwares and different effects within those softwares will use different parts of your computer to perform tasks. Clearly, warp stabilizer is only using an individual speed of one core to perform that task. Also, I did an export test in Final Cut Pro X and both computers actually exported out the same speed. Playback was still better in Final Cut Pro X on the iMac Pro, but there didn't seem to be any advantage with the export speed. So I definitely think there is a point of diminishing returns where you're paying a premium for slight incremental improvements, but that's how it is with most new technology, guys. It's overpriced and you're going to pay a premium for the latest and greatest tech. So is it worth the $14,000 price tag? For most people, no. For a select few, yeah, it may be a difference maker. Do I personally need a computer this powerful? No. I'm sure I'd be just fine with my iMac or a base model iMac Pro. I mostly got this for review purposes to benefit you. But most can't afford Mongo computers like this, I get that. And I often get asked, what are the minimum specs my computer needs to edit video? And it completely depends on the footage that you're editing and the codec of that footage. Every camera has different codecs that work faster or slower with different softwares and effects. The slower your computer is, the slower your workflow is going to be. I've edited Red 8K videos on my MacBook before. It's definitely doable. It's just a lot slower than if I were to use an iMac Pro. So my advice would be to use whatever you got, whatever you can afford, and just start creating content. Start editing videos, and as you begin making money with those videos and increasing the demand for your services, your time will start to become more valuable, and at that point, it would make more sense to upgrade to a faster machine. And I'm sure I'll still get a lot of you telling me, oh, but you could have just built a custom PC for a much lower price with the exact same specs. And yes, that is true, but time is money. And the amount of time it would take me personally to research and build my own PC is far greater than the amount I would save. So it just depends on how much your time is worth. Be smart. Cheaper isn't always better. Don't forget to factor in the opportunity cost. I have nothing against PCs. They're a great option as well. I just prefer Apple. But there you have it. There is a look at the new $14,000 fully loaded 18-core iMac Pro. Hope this comparison was insightful. To learn more about what camera gear is best for you, make sure to check out fulltimefilmmaker.com, where I test out different products in different price ranges to help you decide which products are best for you to buy. And lastly, big thanks once again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. They are an all-in-one website designing platform whom I have personally used and can highly recommend. They have tons of professional looking templates helping you build a professional website for your business in no time. And you can start a free trial today at squarespace.com. And if you end up liking it, be sure to use offer code Parker to get 10% off your first purchase. But that's it. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you have any further questions, please let me know.